So do this. But douche, you will need to sacrifice a lot of permanencer. And we have another obliterator, which we can buff up for plus a lot there. Ah, that's a lot of permanence there, buddy. That's a lot. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? Badoosh! And now we need to sacrifice my dead dude. That's Sarah's emissary. Yes! Oh my god! Woo. Yeah, it's finally time, everybody, for another membership deck. I know it's been a while, but today we're playing Alexandre Bueno de Oliveira's Phyrexian Obliterator fight deck. If you also want to become a member and have a chance to get your deck featured, you can check out the join button or check out my Patreon. Link down in the description. So what is this deck about? It's very, very simple. If you haven't seen this card, we're gonna read it out loud. Whenever a source deals damage to Phyrexian Obliterator, that source's controller sacrifices that many permanents. So you could be lucky and your opponent bolts this. Unlikely. Instead, of course, you're just gonna fight our opponent's creatures, which means that they deal damage to Phyrexian Obliterator and they need to sacrifice as many permanents as their creature had power, which is just amazing. So we have Blizzard Brawl to fight, we have Primal Might to fight, we have Struggle for Scamfor to fight, and then we have a couple of goodies here. So we can ramp into Phyrexian Obliterator so that we can get him down and fight actually as early as turn 3 if we get the Shambling Ghast plus Deadly Dispute down. We can get that off because then we have 5 manas, which is pretty amazing. We also have Ravenous Chupacabra to deal with things on the battlefield. We have a Grey Merchant for a little bit of damage. Vivian to find our creatures. Blood and Snow to return all our goody little goodies. And Massacre Worm to deal with a lot of small tokeny things. Cultivate to ramp. Return to Nature to deal with enchantments and artifacts. And also we're going to see another version of this deck, which is very much focusing in on this fight theme. So the first game, we're going to play this deck. Next game, we're just gonna bring in even more fight cards. That's gonna be hilarious. Let's jump into the games. Yeah, I know. I did some slight tweakings to the deck. So initially, we had a lot of forests, which made it very difficult to play the Phyrexian Obliterator. So I took those out. That's the first thing I did. And now all the mana base is like this. Everything is like black-green almost. I also put in one more Phyrexian Obliterator. We'll see if we'll find it. We haven't found it with this hand. This is easily gonna mulligan. But this looks good. This looks fine. If we don't find this guy in our games, now we've found him, but if that becomes a problem, I think we'll put in the green creature, which makes it so that we can search for a creature. We, like, we discard a creature card, search for a creature card. I think that's gonna be good in a deck like this. I think it could be. We'll see. Another way I thought about bringing this guy in is maybe with reanimation. Isn't there a card? No, it's 3 or less. I was thinking that there's a card for that can animate for 4 or less. Because then we could discard this turn 1, turn 2 return it is what I was thinking. But I don't think we can't do that. Because that would be really, really cool. Because if we could return this guy and fight immediately, that was going to be a big surprise, I think. I'm going to keep this. Ship a blood on the snow. And we're just ready. It's red rock and roll. I just knew them, dude. Go to Lena. What are you gonna do? Deadly Dispute, though. Do we have enough creatures? Oh, yeah, actually, we have the Arborian. The Arborian, so we can maybe get this off. Maybe. Or, I'm thinking, actually, a card we really should have in this deck is... What was I thinking about? The thing. Magma Opus, yeah, okay, this tipple's trickery. We're done, Gantorn! What did... It's not tipple's trickery? Or his tipple's tricking us into thinking it's not... Okay, I don't know. Put down this. Man, There's something nasty. It's a hair. Probably from my mustache, I would guess, but okay. It's creating a lot of treasures. I'm a little bit afraid. How much does this cost, though? 7. So we could get to the Creative Outburst, okay. Tibalt's Trickery. Is it gonna get us? Man, we need this out early. Can we get this down earlier than turn... And with Arboreal Grace, we're gonna get down turn 3. And then if we go first... That should probably be fast enough. But then our opponent also needs to have a creature. No! Oh, but this is not good for you. Don't deal 4 damage, that. Why would you do that? Are you gonna? That's not good at all, sir! Okay. Oh, he dealt to our face, okay. I thought I was gonna deal 4 damage to this. I was like, oh my god, now we have a target to fight though. So that's perfect. Can we buff it? No, no, we can't, unfortunately. Yeah, hello. You see it for Exon Obliterator, Guru Lima. You have seen it. Pinball Tracker, no! Here's what I can do, though. In response to that. No, we can't do it. Oh, we have Foretell, that's why. Okay, I was about to Foretell it. That would have been horrible. Okay, what are we gonna cast? Turn to nature. I think we will decline that thing. And we're gonna struggle for... Oh, we can only foretell it. Oh my god, man, if this was not a foretell thing! Why do we have this? Oh my god! Oh my god, maybe it blocks! Maybe it just blocks! God, but he's lost one people's trickery. There's a chance, everybody. It's a chance. But yeah, this is gonna go out for this game. Out of it! Need just one mana things. We can't gamble on having 4 manas. Way too much. Oh, we didn't have it? We're still in it, everybody. We're still in it somehow, some way. Okay. Unless he has it. Mesix Mastery. But that's not gonna work. I mean, he could Creative Outburst again, I guess. That's not gonna be that good for him, is it? Okay. Gets another dude. Okay, it's 5 damage to our face. We're almost dead though. Maybe it works. Maybe it works. No, we're gonna draw another fight spell. The draw another fight spell is gonna be easy pace of damage. Quick. Okay. Okay, well, you there, my dear dude. You're going where? 4 lands. Get mad. Get mad. Down to 1 land. That's all you get. 1 little land. Nice. Would be nice if there was a buff spell which buffs their creature. That would be so nice. Oh, really though? So I did some slight tweakings to the deck just to maximize on this combo. So I took out the 4 mana thing that we had to fight. And I put in everything that cost 1 mana to can fight. So we have Primal Mind, we have Prey Upon, and we have Blizzard Brawl. And then all the early rampers, you have Lawn of Elves, Arboreal Grazer, and Shambling Ghast. We're still using Deadly Dispute to maybe sacrifice these things, or with discarding the Fallen Shaman, find Phyrex and Obliterator, and badoosh! A schnoosh. But Chris, you say, you took out the board wipes. I know we took out the board wipes. I know. That might come back to hurt us, but here's what I think. I think now we can get Phyrex and Obliterator down so fast. I mean, lightning fast, I think. Possibly. Possibly lightning fast. Okay, put this down. Lawnor Elves. Possibly we could kill the Speaker of the Heavens. He has a fast starter, okay. Smacks him with that. Do we block? I mean, in one way, I kind of feel like blocking. Because this doesn't help us ramp into Rex and Obliterate. I mean, we can sacrifice it, though, to the Deadly Dispute. We block next turn and we sacrifice the Deadly Dispute. And that's gonna be good. So, let's see. We need this here. Right? And then we could also play Primal Might and fight his Speaker of the Heavens, you say. That's probably good, when I think about it. This is not an instant, right? Okay, so one. Kill the Speaker of the Heavens. Badoosh. Badish Badoosh is up 22. But we have a decent board here. We're soon gonna be able to play the Phyrexian Obliterator. Bishop of Wings, though. Beautiful Valkyrie, we're down to 18. But I think we're doing good. I think we're doing good. Let's see. Put down this fool. Use the Deadly Dispute. Get a treasure token. We can actually do this. We can put them all down. Keep up the Deadly Dispute. And pass the turn. I think we're gonna get him. I think we're gonna get him. Hopefully get something big down. Okay, that's not big, but it's fine. Okay. Smacks him with that, smacks him with that. Okay. We'll block with this guy. Yes. Then Deadly Dispute. Sacrifice this guy. Draw 2 cards. Get a treasure. Perfect. Nothing's big so far. He needs a big dude before we reveal the Phyrexian Obliterator, I feel like. These are not instant, these are sorceries. So I think we kill the Speaker of the Heavens, because it's the most dangerous thing he has. I think we kill it, yeah, we'll do this. Unfortunately, we lose a long war for this, but I think it's worth it. We don't play the Obliterator, because then he's just gonna use some kind of exile spell on it. We don't want that. We don't want that. Now this is better, maybe. Okay, choose a creature type. Angel, maybe. Okay, they get a little bit bigger. No block still. Down to 14. Okay, I mean, we can block with this. I wanted to play a big angel before we reveal our stuffs here. Alright, pass the turn. We have a blocker. We take a 2 per turn. That's fine. Don't mind taking 2 per turn. Okay, he goes in with that, though. Goes in with that, you say. We don't need this Fauna Shaman. But on the other hand, we could take 5. Maybe that's just fine. Yeah, sure. Sure. Okay, maybe he doesn't have any big things, and I'm just waiting forever for him to have something. Okay, so we do this then. We prey upon the youthful Valkyrie. And he sacrificed 2 permanents. That's something. He gets a white spirit. Unfortunately, he gets a white spirit there. So he can sacrifice the white spirit. And that guy, okay. Interesting. I'm gonna do no attacks here. We're a little bit in a vulnerable position. Maybe. Maybe, okay. Speak of the heavens. Have another prey upon. That's perfect, okay. Another obliterator. Oh, don't mind if I do. Mind if I do play another obliterator. Do we kill that thing? Yeah, we kill that thing. Come on. It's hilarious. Badoosh. Speak of the heavens. No! Oh. Yep. I'm using sacrifice a permanent. It's probably gonna be this at this point. He could now kill one obliterator, losing all his permanents. It's a possibility for him. Going with these to save the Lawnor and the obliterator unblocks. Down to 17. It's looking good for us, unless he has a board wipe, then we're kind of dead. We'll see. We'll see if he has it. Okay, no. Doesn't have it. Okay, well, we go in with these two. Push in. Have some blockers here. In case he has some nasty stuffs. Okay, it's down to 7. That's good. Can't attack him with the Faceless Heaven, but we have the Deadly Dispute there. If it does. So there's Emissary, though. Ooh. That's gonna be creatures, right? Yeah, I don't think we can do anything against that. I don't think we can do anything. Chris, why did you take out the board wipe? You dingus! Ah, I know. Actually, we... If he blocks... If he blocks... Yeah, he gets protection, but the Obliterator still triggers, because it is dealt damage. Actually works if he fights, still. It actually still works if he fights, okay? Sacrifice the Lawnwell. If we find a fight spell, that should work for us. Right? So we do this, do this. But douche, he will need to sacrifice a lot of permanents here. And we have another Obliterator, which we can buff up for plus a lot there. Ah, that's a lot of permanents there, buddy. That's a lot. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? But douche! Ah. And now we need to sacrifice my dead dude. That's Sarah's Emissary. Yes! Oh my god! Woo. Okay, that game just felt good. That game just felt... Oh my freaking gooners. Good. What are we gonna start off with? Maybe this thing? Bajuka bug? Yep, you there, sir. Lose! Lose your freaking game. Lose! Okay. Island Delver of Secrets. Ooh, I don't like that. Like that one bit. We could, though, fight it with this Shambling Ghast. It's actually kind of perfect. Then we get a treasure also. Bada beesh, bada badoosh. Yeah, fight. We got a treasure. Treasure! Perfect. Now we ramped a little bit. That's amazing. 2 manas. Paturamander. The Manders. Okay. I think we're fine against the Manders. Probably, maybe, we'll see. Oh, he has counterspells. He has freaking counterspells. He has freaking fricks. I knew it! I saw this guy was gonna have freaking fricks. Opt. Okay, let's see here. He needs how many things in the graveyard? A couple of them to be able to adapt there. The man's just gonna be holding up counterspells. No. There's obsession. Okay, I mean, we're gonna have to lure out those counterspells, aren't we? Unless he plays another Cures of Obsession. Maybe he doesn't have a counter for a creature spell though. Oh, now he surely doesn't. Surely doesn't at this point. Okay, so we play this little fool right here. Out of bay. I think we'll have to go for Primal Might immediately. I don't think we can wait on this. I think we have to do it now. Fight that thing, and he loses two permanents. Unless he has Spell Pierce. He had Spell Pierce! Swift Blade! You maniac! I guess maybe you run this now. I mean, it's kind of good against a lot of decks, but frack. Spell Pierce! No! Okay. I guess we can gamble and wrong that fight card, maybe. That'd be good. Otherwise, I think we're kind of out of this game. Because he's just holding counter spells at this point. Yep, that's another thing which can be blocked. I think we're dead. I mean, probably discarding this for another thing. Maybe. Okay. Man, if we had a creature we could help us fight her, that would be amazing. Let's see what another opening right here. I don't know why I'm doing this main phase, it doesn't do anything. Doesn't really do anything for us. I will try to smack in. Maybe we can raise him? I don't think so. Maybe. Okay. Another 15. Yeah, well, we have some power on the board, though. You know, maybe. We draw another fight spell. We put down this. He has to counter this. You know, maybe. Got a lot of cards now, though. A lot of cards in that paramander. Maybe we should do the same. Maybe we should have Cure's Obsession on our obliterators. Maybe, okay. Scanta. Starting to look grim. Will admit, starting to look a little bit grimmer. We can try to start off with the Grazer and see if he gets countered. Because it has reach, okay, so he kind of needs to counter it. Okay. It's gonna take away the obliterator ability. And tap it, okay. And we put down another obliterator. And no attacks. I mean, we have pretty good attacks on the ground, though. To be fair. Gonna flip. Don't flip. Bracket flip. Then one more spell press. Okay, we know he has a spell press, though. That's good. Okay. Like that. Okay, so 7 damage. We're looking kind of dead. But this thing might just be kind of good for us. Thermander. Not dealing any real damage there, okay? Okay, the Prey Upon. Well, we need to attack him first, right? See if he has any more Merfolk Tricksters. Smack him with these guys. Probably takes it. Seems to be the logical thing to do here. We know he has Spell Pierce, but we don't know what other things he has here. So let's go and try and kill up Thermander. That would be nice. We can pay for that Spell Pierce. Unless he has way too many of them. Yeah, pay for one. Does he have another? Pay for that. Does he have a third? Did he draw 4 Spell Pierces? Okay, adapt. Oh, that's not smart, buddy. That's not smart at all. Wow. Oh, you need to sacrifice 7 permanents now. Oh, maybe he does sacrifice every... Oh, he still survives. He's just sacrificed all his lands. And he's fine. Actually was smart. Oh my god. Swift Blade. Okay, he could have sacrificed his Curious Obsessions, although they don't do anything. But I would just probably sacrifice the lands here, right? Okay, guys. You got us, but we got off a fight at least. We didn't go out without a fight. In the true meaning of the word. Word. With the verb. A fighting is a verb, though, so that actually works, okay? Badoosh. Ooh, Deadly Dispute without any creatures. Like Mulligan. Like we just Mulligan. This we can keep. Easily keep. What do we ship though? Ship the long run, like Badoosh. And we go Badoosh, Badish, Badish. Hoo, choo, ha, hoo, 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 hoo. I mean, it's not amazing with a hand like this. Unless we can find our business, but I think we're gonna find our business. Spire block canal. Okay, I guess we go Ghast mode. Ghast! Did we count one? No? Oh, wait, yeah, we counted one. Channeling Ghast. Oh my god, the opportune response, okay. Sure, well, in that case, take away that opt. That opt goes, buddy. We all know it. Badooch! Bang it. Baggage phase, okay, two Shambling Ghasts. And nothing else, really. Would be nice to draw a million cards here. And not a million, but draw a couple here. Shoot, if we could find the thing which sacrifice these things and draw cards. Those cards. Okay, Arcanist. Well, that's what I think. We smack him with these two. He might block one. He might. Oh, right. Actually, let's see here. We don't have enough snow to trigger the thing. Okay. Well, you know what? That's fine. That's fine. This is an instant. No, the sorcerer. Man, can't it be an instant fight spell? Why can't those exist? I guess because then you can fight something which has a sacrifice effect. Would be good with evoke creatures and stuff. I know, but still. And this effects. Instant. Instant. We need Teferi. Old Teferi. We need him back. Okay. I mean, now we could kill the Dreadnought Arcanist, but I don't know. Okay, smack in. So now we're gonna block. We're gonna take it again. Take it again. Okay. Okay. Okay, buddy, I say. Let's see. We get give him a little minus here. Then we do a Blizzard Brawl. We get a treasure. I mean, it's not the best thing ever. It's not the best thing ever. Because we're losing our Shambling Ghast also. But, I mean, we're doing something here. Doing something, okay? Don't miss Vito though. Oh my god, but what do you know? We have another. We have another, buddy. We have another. Why didn't you die? Did we have three snow power? We did not. We don't have three more snow. Why did you survive there? Yo, because we gave him minus before. Minus! Minus! Okay. Esper Sentinel and Luminarch Aspirin. Put the counter on there. Schmurt. Schmurt, schmurt, buddy. Yeah, I'm gonna play this. Okay. And smack him with the Shambling Ghast. Dealing a lot of damage. Smacking in pretty hard so far. Okay. Unholy Hate! Oh my god, okay. Smack him with you then. Beating down just the Shambling Ghast. He's down to 16. We brought him down lower, buddy. Okay, oh my god, himself. Now we can block with a Born Grazer. That's great. That's great. Giving more value to our Grazer. Don't mind that. Oh, they have a, oh my god, he has a fight spell. No, lightning in this guy. Oh, heals up, huh? Up to 19. And another lightning. Just for good measure. Okay. Let's see here. Ah, that's why he buffed it before. Man, this guy thinks ahead. I would not have done the same. We'll admit, we'll not have done the same. Oh my god, I'm land. Okay, I'm down. It'd be perfect to fight this guy, though, if we ever find the Phyrexian dude. I'm gonna go ahead and say. Okay. Back in, we are looking kind of close to that there. Not dead yet. Looking close to that. Not dead yet. Not dead. Should we have Mulligan again? Maybe we should have. Maybe we should have, okay. We'd rather Arcanist, no? Rage Chandler! Channeling the Rage. If there are four or more types of cards in your graveyard, it gets plus two, plus two. Okay. Can we find it now? No. Didn't find it. Didn't even find it. This hand I believe in. Shambling Ghast into Deadly Depute. Man, if we find the Phyrexian Obliterator with this hand, like imagine going turn one, Shambling Ghast, turn two, Deadly Dispute, turn three, play that thing, play Blizzard Brawl, hopefully has a 10-10 down at that point or something, and we just clear his board. That'd be great. Is that gonna happen? probably find out. And find out the power of jank, I think. I'm gonna seep into this deck and it's gonna make it so freaking good now. We're gonna clash everything. Mountain, is this tip? I said it again. Almost said it. I said it, I almost said it, and I said it, and I almost said it again. Nah. Okay, Shaman Ghast. He's gonna burn it immediately. Burn it with fire, give me a treasure. Maybe. Maybe does that, maybe doesn't. Actually bad for us if he burns it. Because then we can't use Deadly Dispute. And all we have is Primal Might and Prey upon. And Blizzard Brawl. Okay. Right, dead. And dead, but maybe we'll find another creature. Maybe. Possibility, okay? Mato Cristo. Humanas. Nothing. We're gonna... Oh my god, we can actually use Deadly Dispute. It's a sacrifice of treasure! Oh, I forgot about that! Okay, we're gonna use that end of his turn. Maybe draw into a land or something, eh? Peltician Elector. Sure. And end of our turn here. Use this. Sacrifice this. Draw two cards. Find something good. Something good. Okay. It is something. It is something, actually. I think since we have this many Primal Mites, we'll just fight that thing. We'll do a plus one. And Badoosh. Yes. Oh, he has a buff spell. And he gets us. Does he have a buff spell? He has his own Primal Might. No, that's a sorcery. Oh my god, Lightning Strike! Oh my god! Okay, yeah. That was bad. That was bad. That was bad. I should have kept up the Deadly Dispute, I guess. Okay. Let's buff. We're down to 12. It's not looking good, but can we get the... No, not the Obliterator. We'll try to draw into it. Maybe? No. No Obliterators. Maybe we should keep hands without Obliterators. Because we're not doing anything if we don't find it. Yeah. We're kind of bad, aren't we? Unless we find the Obliterator now? No. No. We need the Obliterator. Okay, we don't keep unless we have either a card we can search for the Obliterator or the Obliterator. We've learned that now. We've learned our lesson. We played this game, we learned our lessons. And now we are ready to... I mean, Fallen Shaman we can keep, right? We ship our Arboreal Grazer, which can't do anything anyways. And we find our business, and we're gonna be easy winnings. Easy! Asha Wee, Asha Boo, Asha Pop, you gonna do? Added in some spicy drums there. Okay, Haunted, Chris, not Haunted. Haunted, yes, I know. Or is it Haunted? Oh, it is Haunted. I thought it was Haunted, but it was okay. I don't know why I thought it was Haunted! That doesn't create a ghost, so now, okay, now I look like a Bengus. Okay, it is Haunted, it was. Ah, oh, my brain. Main. That little bit of art there, you say? This was... I think we put down this, right? We ship the... Do we kill this Usher the Fallen now? No, we don't. That would be stupid, you say. Then it dies. We could also... No, we don't have enough green. Okay. We might actually block with this on Usher the Fallen, because we don't want this to create a lot of tokens. Okay. And see if it comes in. Okay, return our creature card. Okay, gains our life point. Interesting. And my turn. That is Perfecta Mundo. I think this Arboreal Grazer is not going to do anything here. Instead, what we want is, of course, the Grace. Or Obliterator. By Grace, I mean Obliterator. Do we put him down now and risk him getting exiled? Yes, because we don't have a land maybe next time. So, well, found this. A beach. I don't think he wants to attack in there, unless he has an exile speller. Does he have an exile spell, or does he not? Okay, well then he's gonna be in trouble. And he's gonna be in a lot of trouble here. Yeah, we're gonna fight this Usher the Fallen. First order of business. You're gonna have to sacrifice two permanents. But they're dude! Two permanents, Haunted Witness. Not Haunted, Chris. Haunted Witness, yes. And he creates a 1-1. But that's perfect, because that just gives us another target to fight. Badoosh. Sacrifice another permanent. Mm-hmm. Sacrifice another one. But which one's gonna be? Land? Ooh, Abiding Grace, okay. And smack in for all the damages. Devouring Light, no! Raggers. Well, we can sacrifice the Fallen Shaman, though. Now we can discard it. Discard the Fallen Shaman. Badoosh. Search for another Obliterator. Great. Put down the Obliterator. Hopefully you can put down some big dudes instead of these guys, which are actually good. Guess what we're playing here. Frack. Yes, the anti-obliterator deck. No! Oh my god, really? No way. Okay, why? Would you do this? The bar and life, Chris. I know. Fell for it twice. Or blocking, okay? Sure. Okay, I think I've learned what the card does now. I think. Can't be 100% sure, but... Let's see. See, I might just fall for it again, everybody. Attacking or blocking, yeah? Okay. Really? Really, though? Really, though? Really, though? Because I don't like that. At all. I mean, I don't think he likes that we are searching up four obliterators, but... Sure. Can we now play this? Can you play a big creature, sir? Because I don't want to fight your Doomed Traveler. Like, I don't. Maybe I should have bought it. That forces him down the very... Oh my god, that's perfect. That is amazing. Don't have another exile card, please. Okay, good. Yeah, there's gonna be a brawler between that Usher the Fallen. This dude. So one thing that's gonna die is his Doomed Traveler, surely. And then what else is gonna sacrifice the Paladin class, maybe? I don't think he wants to give us another Obliterator. It's a Flyer. I'll smack in. He doesn't really have a good box here, so. We're down to 13. Good. Okay. Planes. Having only small dudes actually working to his advantage here, gotta say. Okay, blocks there. He's back in. He's down to 8. And he can't use the Castle Arden Veil for a while, huh? Okay. Abiding Grace. Return a creature card with mana value 1 from his graveyard to the battlefield. Ooh, that's kind of nice, actually. I should have fallen. Can we search for something bigger with the Fallen Shaman? I think we've searched for all our obliterators. Don't have any more of those. We're gonna search for another Fallen Shaman. Two twos at least. At least they're freaking two twos. Okay, smack in. Down to 3. Yep. One more hit from this obliterator, and that should be it. Oh my god! Snowdo! Thank you everybody so much for watching, and a special thank you of course to the latest members of Yoin, which are Cryptic Gladiator, Omar Jimenez, Asfasi, English Teacher, and Alexandre Bueno de Oliveira. Oliveira in the Riviera.
Hello, Daniel!
And you are?
It's me, the YouTube algorithm.
And what are you doing here?
I'm just here to take those views.
No, those are my views.
Oh, I can explain to you, senor. You see, you have subs 0% and non-subs 100%. That's why you can take all your views.
I guess it's time that you check out a little. The thing down there.